It's depressing. It's sad. The institution itself is designed to protect itself, and that includes its own corruption. So I'm fired up. I'm angry.
The request for a new trial denied for his client. This afternoon, Judge William Hooks ruled that George Anderson will remain behind bars, serving a life sentence for the murders of two children back in the early 90s.
Obviously, he's disappointed. I mean, obviously, this is overwhelming.
In his order, Judge Hooks felt Anderson's testimony was not credible and that there was no medical evidence to support the claim that he was beaten and tortured during a lengthy interrogation. Anderson alleges the abuse happened at the hands of three former Chicago police detectives who worked under the infamous commander, John Burge.
Multiple different police officers that played a part in Anderson's arrest have upwards to 50 to 100 complaints of systematic police torture.
How much proof do you need to have to show a pattern?
Judge Hooks felt Anderson jumped on what he called the Burge torture bus, painting himself as a victim. The state's attorneys who worked on the case wouldn't speak on camera, but said they feel justice was served and say that the murderer of two young children will remain in prison.
This is not justice.
Everybody believes in fairness. Everybody believes in due process. And unfortunately, we didn't get that today.
Anderson's attorney, though, says he's not giving up. His next plan is to move this case on to the First District Court of Appeals.